الله أكبر الله أكبر.
Sister Saba from Canada, and she's asking what advice you have on keeping and helping someone to keep their iman, because sometimes she feels that her iman decreases.
Alhamdulillah, we are now in the best time of the year, in Ramadan. We alternate between fasting and the recitation of the Quran and praying at night, and these are all great factors to increase the level of iman in our hearts. The recitation of the Quran is very, very important to be maintained in Ramadan and after Ramadan. It is very important for Muslims to have a daily word or sabak in order to maintain their ties and their relationship with their Creator. Praying on time, when the Prophet ﷺ was asked about the best deed ever, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to offer the prayer on its first appointed time. As-salatu ala waqatiha. Whenever you feel that you committed a sin, it is not proper to say it's a small sin, it's a minor sin versus a major sin, it's nothing. No, it's not you who decide. Muslims, with regards to their evil deeds or sins, they look at them as mountains. They're about to collapse on top of their heads. And with regards to their good deeds, they look at it with fear that it might not be accepted. Mm-hmm. So keeping balance between hope and fear would keep the person always steadfast on the straight path by the leave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Giving any charity would erase your sins and would protect you from calamities and so forth, and would increase the level of your iman. If you are a male, it is recommended to pay regular visits to the graveyard. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I have prohibited you in the past from visiting the graveyard. Now I'm recommending for you to resume visiting the graveyard, since it will remind you with death. Remembering death is the most important factor of reviving us. Reviving us, are we dead? Yes. Whenever we are busy with our worldly activities, we're absent-minded. And whenever we see somebody is dying or died, then we wake up. We realize that we're running out of time. So remembering death, visiting sick people, giving in a charity, visiting the graveyard, making certain that every once in a while you go somewhere where you know that this masjid is a major masjid where they offer the Salatul Janazah or the funeral prayer. So you go and attend, because these are the acts which, number one, would increase the level of your iman. Two, will increase the asset and the balance of your good deeds and raise you in ranks before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah knows best.
أنا العبد الذي كسب الذنوب وصدته
تخيل يوم أن ينادي الجبار يقول فلان
عبد الذي يضحى بحديث
ففروا إلى الله
يقول فلان أتذكر يوم كذا وكذا أتذكر يوم كذا وكذا أما من تاب وآمن أما من لقي الله بقلب منيب أما من لقي الله خائفا خاشعا
ففروا إلى الله
فيقرره الله بذنوبه حتى إذا ظن العبد أنه فلك قال أرحم الراحمين
أنا العبد الذي سطرت عليه
إلى الله
فإني تترتها لك في الدنيا وإني أخذها لك اليوم فيؤتى كتابه بيمينه فينطلق بين الصفوف ضاحكا مسرورا ها اقرأوا كتابي إني ظننت أني ملاق حسابي ها اقرأوا كتابي
ففروا إلى الله
تخيل يوم أن ينادي الجبار النتيجة فهو في عيشة راضية في جنة عالية قطوفها ثانية كلوا واشربوا هنيئا بما قدمتم في الأيام الخالية عقول البشر فاز فلان ولا فاز فلان.
فالفر إلى الله.
فلم أرى الشبيبة والمشيبة